about the Squirts.
About the Squirts?
Yeah. The bad band.
I never heard of them.
Oh, don't say that. See? Just make shit up, dude.
I thought you were talking about, all right, my bust.
You know, the Squirts.
The Squirts, all right. I was thinking the fucking Squirts is the fucking day after Budweiser, but cool. We'll work with this. We'll work with this, great.
No, for real.
The Squirts. Hey, dude, you know what? I like the music. I'm fucking good with it. Hey, I tell you what, I'd like to go to a bar, hear them every night because it's mellow. You ain't got to get in fucking trouble. Just sit back, listen to fucking music, going about your business. Cool?
I got no idea.
Thank you. That's the fucking best thing that's been said on the whole fucking tape.
And I'm a Marine Corps recruiter.
All right. See? The fucking Marine Corps is behind the Squirts.
We thank you.
No. Squirts are behind the Marine Corps.
The way the band started was Andrew or Dick Squirt and Beater and Monkfish, aka Keith Zarczynski, and this guy named Ted, who owned X Records in Greenville, where we were going to start a band. And Ted played guitar and Keith played guitar, and Andrew doesn't play anything, and Beater plays drums. And I was playing bass for another band called Space Goods. And we were in the kind of in the midst of breaking up. We had like a few more shows left, but you know, one of the guys was moving out of town, so we were about to break that band up, and they needed a bass player. So I said, yeah, what the heck? You know, I'm not really doing anything right now. And I kind of thought it would be a temporary thing until I found something else. But we got together, and I guess the first time was Ted and Andrew and Beater and I. Keith couldn't make it for some reason or another. And after one practice, we decided there was no way we were going to play with this guy. And all he knew was a few surf riffs and Blitzkrieg bop. And that was pretty much it. And we're like, I don't know about all that. So then the four of us, Keith and Andrew and Beater and I, started rehearsing. And we did a couple shows, and Keith was pretty much the worst guitarist that's ever played. I mean, we'd be playing a song and he'd be playing an entirely different song, but he didn't have any structure of the entirely different song he's playing, just chords at random, more or less. So at this point, I still hadn't found any other prospects, so I said, well, I'll switch over to lead guitar and we'll get a bass player and put Keith on rhythm where he can kind of turn him down and keep him under control, more or less. And that's when Paul came into the band.
My name's Paul. The band name I go is Johnny Alpha. Of course, the only time I'm ever actually mentioned in a song, they call me Paul, so using a band name is kind of stupid. 1995, maybe, 94, I was working with Andrew. Allowed to like reveal other people's secret identities, he just asked if I wanted to play bass for their band. It was already around Squirts, because Jerry was at the time playing bass with them, and I guess they weren't very satisfied with that, so they wanted another bass player. And you know, being a well-known and well-respected bass player in the area, of course, I was the first person they turned to.
Well, we started out playing in Clemson, South Carolina, and we played a few shows, and everyone was sick of us, so no one would let us play anymore. So then we had to start going out of town and looking for ways to make our livelihood, which wasn't very lively. We went to Florida, other parts of South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, played all over the place. Put out a cassette called Crossing the Hall. It sucked. but then we imploded after about 2.5 years, and no one's heard the likes of us since.
So do you think people will respond to your reunion tour?
Probably not. We have a few fellow drunks that'll probably show up. Long-time followers, you know. But as far as large-scale turnouts, I doubt it. Unless we get a good opening act, maybe somewhere. Somebody that people like. Then maybe people will come see us. Or they'll probably just leave before we get on stage.
Did that happen a lot?
Yeah. Well, they'd either leave before we got on stage, or they'd hear about two songs and then leave. They always used to yell stuff at us, you know, like you suck and go fuck yourself. That always hurt my feelings. But, you know, I don't let that bother me anymore, because I'm a fucking star. Look at my lifestyle here. I got a candle. Life couldn't be better.
Ooh. What do you think the essence of the Squirts music is? Was it just beer, or did you have a deeper message?
Free beer.
Chef pants, these are jail pants.
What's up there, bean eater?
What's the problem?
No problem.
Chris Ellenburg is supposed to bring girls.
Hello. Yeah, is Chris Ellenburg working tonight? Chris Ellenburg. Alright. All right, thanks, man. Bye. He's already left for the day.
Maybe Johnny Ray went somewhere. I don't know. Johnny's not there. And his car's not there.
You think they might be downtown drinking somewhere?
No, Johnny didn't really go out drinking. He'd be hanging out in Key Street, be the only place, because his girlfriend works there.
I wonder if Chris maybe went up, maybe if Chris is up at Nick's or somewhere. Mm-hmm. This is a dilemma.
Yeah.
Does Johnny Ray have drums?
Yeah.
Dude, we never knew that many songs.
Not at one time, but this is everything we've ever played live. I'm not kidding.
All right. I'm going to do Leaving Texas. No, just...
A lot of these, I don't remember the music to. I just wrote them down.
Just
scribble out the ones we don't want to do.
We're definitely starting with Jerry's Rap.
God, I really don't want to do that. But
There's Beater. We got to find some drums, man.
Oh, but we got some.
Well, Chris is supposed to bring him, but he hasn't shown up yet.
Yeah, we haven't heard.
I haven't heard from him.
Yeah, me and you may have to go look for somebody to get some drums in just a few minutes, man.
Do you know what
do you want to get rid of any of these covers? Do you want to keep any of these covers?
Let's see.
There's the one you wrote that kind of sounded like a Sun Brand sort of song.
We recorded it. And I thought that was Miss Contrary because they started booing.
No, silly
thing. That was Keith's song, Miss Contrary.
More or less.
My cheesy ass lyrics, dude.
I kind of remember Leaving Texas. I remember Where the Squirts. I remember The Lamb. I remember Beer Saved My Life. I don't remember Skeleton Key at all. Sound of Wings, I remember. Number One Delicious, I remember. If Paul remembers Big Star and Skeleton Key, I think I can get the rest of it.
Gonna walk away.
Yeah.
I've got nothing to say. I'm probably gonna just have to write new lyrics to most of these songs, man.
New songs.
Well, that Skeleton Key is on that tape.
Yeah, most of these are on that tape.
Alright.
In fact, everything that you haven't crossed off is on that tape except for Suck My Dick While I Take a Shit.
Okay.
Both of them think they're responsible for, any success that we've had. All the songs that are popular, either one of them will claim having written. Most of our good ones, I think, have kind of just been a group project, which is why I think they're good. Everybody's kind of contributed equally from an original idea. I don't think it matters. None of the concepts of the songs are so deep that anybody can really brag about the idea of the song. We're the Squirts. Okay, we're the Squirts. It's not a deep concept.
Did you call him, Paul? You know his number?
You got Paul's number on you?
Nobody's answering. Probably. Hey, Paul, it's John. We're all over at Jerry's, so you should be here too. So we'll see you in a few minutes. Bye. That was disappointing.
Some drums so we can have our first practice in 5 years. So Beater can have some drums to play on, because he's a drummerless drummer.
It's too cheap to buy him.
He is. He's a cheap little bastard. He buys like porn and jacks off to little kitty fuckers all the time, but he won't buy a damn drum kit. So we're drinking. But I mean, we'll start looking again in a minute.
We have,
you don't want that, do you?
Woo!
not fucking asleep.
Come on, jump.
There you are. You ready to go?
Sometimes everybody gotta be done.
First of all, we don't have any drums yet, which is the biggest obstacle to overcome.
Yeah.
I'm trying to find out where Chris is. And I don't know what time we gotta be done. I don't have any particular time. I don't know if those guys do.
Well, Andrew probably has to work tomorrow. It's all because Jerry let his drums go. We won't be able to do shit tonight.
We can except hang out and drink beer.
Just come over. We'll fucking sit around and like make some decisions and shit about what we're gonna play. Have a couple of beers, and then I'll bring you back by. You wanna do that?
Well, I'm gonna drive. I'm gonna jump in the shower real quick. I'm gonna drive over there.
Okay.
I fucking fell asleep on that leather couch. I'm like totally soaked through.
All right. Well, we'll be over there.
Okay.
Come on over.
Fire. I'll see you, Steve.
No, he's out there.
He's gonna. Who is? Sir Hall?
Yeah, he's out for the season anyway.
Yeah, he's gone for the season, man. You couldn't handle Budweiser. You had to go one step down.
One step, yeah. Man. That's like four steps.
Oh, yeah.
When I enter a room of inferior beings, I like to bring my own consumables.
Inferior beings. This is what the guy hasn't been laid since the Squirts broke up.
Oh!
So some people judge their lives by more than the amount of sex.
Oh, they
have.
Yeah, they judge it by computer games. By all of mine.
No. Nope, not at all. Judge
nothing
by maybe goals in life.
And I see
yeah, but at least I haven't reached my goal yet. We're sitting in your goal.
I think that's a deep cut, man.
Sitting in your goal right now.
I am highly insulted. We made a list of everything. I wrote down everything we ever played, and we crossed off everything that none of us wanted to play.
Or couldn't remember.
Or couldn't remember.
Well, our final original list is Leaving Texas, We're the Squirts, Lame, Beer Saved My Life, Skeleton Key, Sound of Her Wings, Number One Delicious, Big Star, and She Sucked My Dick While I Was Taking
What was
the
Number
shit.
One Delicious?
That was New York City. It's easy. I know that song.
Oh, it was New York City? Okay.
And then Beer. But Beer is not worth mentioning. It's 1 second long.
What? It's worth mentioning.
Well, I mean, it's not really going to fill up any time in a set.
Our set doesn't fill up any time.
And then the only two covers that anybody wanted to do, we figured you wanted to do Astro Zombies. I don't really give a shit about any of them.
I don't know. I had nothing to do with it. I thought there were two. Right here. It's no big deal to me.
No, I just mean like last night.
I had to work today too. I didn't have any time to mess around with it.
I forgot that I was going to have to drink tonight.
Bye.
Said, man, I thought they were going to get hold of me or something. I don't have a rod. I ain't got no way to transport the drums or anything.
Where the fuck was he?
He said he was at King Street all day. And I was like, well, they went by there and you weren't there. And he's like, well, I went home at 5:30. And I was like, fuck, I ain't got nothing to do with it.
Dude, what time did I call him over here?
I don't know.
I didn't get over here until 6:30. And his mother said she hadn't seen him since yesterday.
We'll be right back.
Like that better?
Play it without the pedal.
Paul said he wanted me to play with the pedal.
Well, for practice, you don't have to, so we can fucking...
Well, I need to figure out a sound. G, C, D, E.
Those mean little to me.
G, C, E, D.
What do you remember?
Clemson, right here.
I just wish I had some fun.
We're the hardest core motherfuckers in this town, and this is what we're doing. And this is exciting to us.
Have you heard the new Paul Westenberg CD?
I've never heard any Paul Westenberg CD.
Oh, shit.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm fucking ready.
Are you ready?
Yeah. I thought you were a punk rock.
I never tried to walk a straight line. I'm the biggest loser of all time.
See that street sign over there? The one that says road construction?
Yeah.
I almost brought it down one night.
On purpose?
Yeah, I climbed the fucking thing and started beating the hell out of it.
I'm down and out, now I'm down. I student keeped in every bar in town. What is that, dude? What do you think about that distortion, dude? That shit, I mean, that's like treble Maximus. Yeah, I mean, that's horrible, dude.
He always played it low. It was...
No. This is like... His amp has always been trebly,
yeah.
But now he's gotten a treble
pedal.
My life's a mess and I'm in disgrace. Even my mom don't wanna see my face.
This is a face of computer cripple that, you know, jerk-offitis.
At least Beater doesn't
I sit up to 5 o'clock in the morning.
I forgot what I was gonna say. Don't matter anyway, cause this ain't my life. This ain't my life. This ain't my life.
Well, I will give Jerry this. He's dedicated a large chunk of his life to perfecting his art. I mean, he spent 17, 18 years of his life playing the guitar, and you can see the results. They speak for themselves.
He's persistent. Jesus Christ, was I that drunk?
You can at least give us a 10-15% commitment.
Can't do it. I'm writing like a few new songs for the new band, so.
When's the next time your new band's playing?
Tomorrow.
Where?
Here.
I mean, like playing here? A show.
I don't know.
Okay, give us 10%. Learn a song.
Just learn one fucking song.
I learned everything that I know. New York City, Center Wings, Where the Squirts, Leaving Texas.
So, okay, Paul, it's dependent on you to teach him the rest of the songs.
You got two songs to show me, Big Star and
Skeleton
King. Skeleton
and Lame.
Okay, and Lame. Three.
All right, so the next time we get together, then I'll know all the songs. Yep. Which will be fine now that I found my tape. I couldn't find my tape before, so. Jerry's got it on fucking CD. Let me borrow that CD.
No, I can't. Did you have a little book?
Oh, Jesus Christ, Jerry. I'll bring it back tomorrow so I can make copies for everybody.
From the Clash, yeah, not from us.
Are we going to do a
book of lyrics?
No, you had your little notebook.
Oh, no.
Hey,
who the fuck?
Why don't we try and do something else before we leave?
Okay, what do you want to do?
Any song that I told you I know.
Get your lazy ass up and get in here.
Dirty, and they still want to go see fucking Star Wars? Who gives a shit? Fucking who cares?
You sit at home and watch movies about fucking guys with pussies. I mean, Hedwig and his angry inch, which is a metaphor for you, right?
At least I got laid this year.
I didn't know I got laid.
Why is that the only thing you can keep bringing up?
By who, Shannon?
Yeah.
That's the only thing you can keep bringing up.
That's the only one that'll touch you.
You know what?
Only one will touch you.
It's getting laid a lot more than you guys.
So what? That's because we don't care.
It's because you couldn't do it.
No, it's because we have standards.
No, you don't. Colleen was the standard. Shannon's the standard, yeah. Primo, guys.
Are you fucking saying shit about Colleen?
Dude, Colleen was a hot chick, man.
You're saying shit about Colleen?
You're dating, I'm sorry, but yo, I'm going to bring this up. You're dating Robo Jerry, okay? She's no Colleen. My Jesus Christ, give me a fucking break.
Robo Jerry, what are you
And she's at? No fucking Shannon either for that fucking...
Well, not on an intellectual level, maybe, but then again, what is Shannon? Get all defensive. You about a girl you haven't seen in 5 years, and you about a girl.
She was a girl that I thought I was gonna fucking marry, and the reason that I haven't had sex with anybody in 3 fucking years, so don't step on shit we don't fucking know anything about.
Woo! I heard that!
There are some things that's fucking fun and fine for your friends to make fun of, and there are some things that fucking aren't, and that's one of the ones that's not.
Yeah, I think so, you happened to be in my house, and
I don't give a fuck.
So therefore, my rules.
Fucks has to do with anything. I was in your house before, and you fucking.
Hey, you sure I know she's are. Closer. Feel blood pressure rise. First two lines.
What? Have what?
I know she's close, I feel the blood pressure rise.
Darkness falls, full moon, fills velvet sky. Blanket of stars, it's my waking dream. All is quiet except the sound of her wings.
What's that song about?
Can we try something else?
It's based on Percy Bysshe Shelley's.
Can we try Louie Louie?
How the hell is that Percy Bysshe Shelley? What song is that based off of?
Just a conglomeration of a lot of his imagery. The whole moon and women predominant and Catholicism.
No, all you said was like just about him or about his writing.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of what I borrow is from famous poets.
Too fucking hard.
Let's at least try and play the music. Just mumble the fucking words.
Too fucking hard.
That's all you do, Laura.
No, it's not like you ever said verbatim anything I wrote.
We want everybody to hear you talk about the celestial bodies in constant motion with...
Yeah, no, it starts off...
It's like a NASA song, dude.
You need to write these down. Don't fucking tell me you're fucking eloquent. You're pseudo-eloquent. I can't fucking hang with that.
Oh, I got it written down.
I'm glad.
You had it written down too, though. I remember you used to.
Yes. I don't have anything stage, written down anymore. What do you think? It's been 5 years since we played. Do you think I took all like the fucking song notes and just like fucking framed them?
Shit. Yes.
Actually, tonight turned out a lot better than I thought it was going to.
Why?
We sounded better than I thought we were going to, or we worked things out better than I thought we were going to.
Really?
In a way, maybe.
I didn't.
You didn't sound better, or you didn't think we sounded better?
I didn't think any of us sounded better.
Scarecrow, what are you? You fucking white belly fucking bald bastard. I'm gonna look younger than you.
Yeah, because I'm the one that's 30 and looks like I'm 23.
I no, you don't.
I get told that all the fucking time. You can kiss
whatever.
My ass.
Hey, you like the one day a month you go out?
I get told all the time. I get told all the time.
Because I don't go out and fucking get drunk and pass out at fucking Tiger Town Tavern. Doesn't mean I don't go out.
You just
because I don't fucking come hang out with you.
Watching video games.
I come and hang out with you.
I get told all the time that I don't look 31, but I don't believe a fucking word of it. I mean,
I get told that I look like 24 rather than 25.
Well, you are 24, you fucking cocksucker.
Somebody that reads as much as you thinks that morals equal religion, then you're a fucking idiot.
No.
Straight up idiot.
Morals equals religion.
No.
Ethics
morals.
Do not.
No. No, morals do not either.
I'm gonna go get a porno, dude. I'm going to
morality is
gonna get a porno.
Yeah, dude.
No. Your morals might be defined by religion, but mine aren't.
I'm gonna go get a club magazine.
Morality versus
fucking okay, so you're playing a semantics game. Whatever. Ethics. I don't give a fuck. I'm a decent person. I don't give a fuck about that shit.
6, 7. I'm gonna go buy a porn from the hot little Indo chick.
You gonna go buy a magazine?
Yeah, dude.
You have
some movies?
I got fucking bags of movies.
Loan me a movie, dude. I'm living at my parents' house. Okay, let's go.
I'm going now. Unless you want to wait till I finish my beer, then you can.
Finish your beer, let's go.
I'm not gonna slam my beer so you can fucking get your nut.
You need a little bit of liquid in here. Yeah, I think that'll do it. I think that'll work out. Yeah. It'll run fine now, don't worry about it.
I don't even know why he sticks around here. I mean, there's no reason for him to be here. He delivers pizzas for a living. I don't know what kind of existence that is. I mean, he knows about computers, and he's one of those computer geek guys, so I'm not sure why he doesn't get a job doing that and get the, you know, move the hell out of here. But, like I said, these guys are, I guess, typical Generation X, which is not to say that I'm not, but at least I have an idea of where I'm going and what I'm doing. Andrew is, he's gone to culinary school, so he's, the executive chef is what you call, I don't know, the head chef of a restaurant, but I don't know if he's really satisfied with that, and he went to school to teach history, and he did that for a while, and then he got sick of it, and now, I don't know. I don't think he has any idea what he's doing. I don't think he ever will. You know, and he's one of those people that's never happy unless he's miserable, so he'll probably always be miserable. And I guess be happy.
Jerry. I first heard of Jerry from a guy named Wavy Davey. He told me about a guy he knew that played guitar.
I've seen a lot of his bands over the years. I'm sure you'll hear about it from him. And they're all decent bands. He tends to write the lyrics and stuff like that. He's good on stage. He's definitely good on stage. He likes to wear velvet and, you know, feather boas and all that. He's got a good rock and roll stage personality. He's, you know, he is a rock star in his mind. And it comes out on stage, and it can be very entertaining. And Beater's a really nice guy. He's really easy to get along with. I don't think he has any direction in his life, really. He's just still trying to find himself. I think everybody in the band is trying to find himself, but he's the only one that doesn't make a big deal out of it. Seems the most comfortable with where he's at in life right now.
These guys, you know, can barely, you know, learn a punk rock song, much less anything I was trying to write. I was trying to write things that are more elaborate, and which eventually I did in bands subsequent to the dissolution of the Squirts. But they just want to play the same freaking songs we learned in the first, you know, 2 months of getting together. And then, I don't know, there's a big personality conflict between Andrew and myself. And I don't know, you can only stand so much of Paul's sarcasm. Beater's all right, I don't really have anything against him. He's just like drunk and silly. That's all he can say about him.
Well, the Squirts have been talking about getting back together for, you know, probably since 6 months after they broke up. Jerry and Andrew, I like playing music, and I'll admit that it is a lot of fun being on stage. I think Jerry and Andrew, as we've said, you know, with the rock star mentality, they thrive off of it and almost have to have it. And I think because they were getting on in life and it's harder to, you know, find people that are willing to play music, so they were having trouble. And I think they were trying to get us back together more just because they thought it was a guaranteed, you know, fix for them to be able to get together and play and get up on stage.
The reunion to me is I'd like a chance to play for the fans, really, like the people that showed up to our shows, then, you know, give them one more go around. As far as the rest of the band, I think it's kind of cool that they'll all be able to get back on stage, because I've been on stage since then and they haven't. So I guess that's kind of cool for them.
But who cares about them? It's about me, right?
Hey, ladies.
Hello.
You look like Andre the Giant.
Yeah, she kind of did. Come, Sherry.
Cool dance. She wants. She's pumped. She's ready to go.
She called my house.
Yeah,
she called, I gave her your number. She called down to the place in Athens, and I gave her your number.
She's excited.
She's real excited.
Really? Stupid.
I know your little pee-pee never made her excited, so it's good to see the Squirts did.
Well, you know, it's hard to get excited over something that's only 2 inches long. So.
A little crude.
Chris, yeah, just give me a call.
Well, I'll
crude?
Do that, Jerry.
Bye.
You guys try not to, like, kill each other.
We'll see.
Or kill Jerry, that is.
You can't kill us already dead.
Okay.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
All right.
Thanks again for the drum.
Call me.
Yeah, man. Just
I'm
don't, like,
hook you up with something special.
Yeah, just don't, like, start smoking crack and decide to pawn them, you know, because I actually want them back.
Call Nathan.
Know, sometime. I'll call Nathan.
I'm going to squeeze on your spot.
So what are you doing here right now?
I don't know, really. I brought my drums here to let the Squirts borrow them.
What do you think of them and their music?
Well, they're a bunch of fuck dicks, personally, but I always thought they were a rather decent punk rock band, you know, except for Jerry, of course, and Andrew. But other than that, the rhythm section's pretty good, I think. The lead singer and the guitarist, they're both assholes.
Pull that door closed.
All right.
And it's locked already.
This one too?
Yeah. I don't want anybody coming in.
I'd like to end with Beer Saved My Life.
So I remember Skeleton Key working with. On a flash of inspiration.
And you guys each pick one cover. And I think that you and I, Paul, ought to each write one new song, whether they actually make it onto the playlist or not. We ought to each write one song.
I've already got mine.
You remember that one, Fuck Dick?
I got it. Like it's yesterday, like riding a bike.
Alright, you ready?
Yeah.
Do the sound of the wings, I know that.
Okay.
And then we'll try
to
spell
the
key. I'm not sure
about that. You got words right down there.
Hold the to the sound of the wings.
Yeah.
It's got ether in there.
I haven't dug them up. Yeah, just, I mean, you just make up words for now. I'll write them down for the end of the night. Starts off the bass. Not super fast. Not that slow either.
Like, play it. Instead of stopping, just play it. I don't know.
I'm not gonna just play the note constantly. It sounds silly. Alright, either mirror what you're doing or I'm just gonna do what I just did.
And we can try and figure out what it was you used to play.
I don't remember.
It's not worth the effort. I'm going to have fun doing this. I don't want to sit there and like
right apart
fry my brain. I'm happy with the...
I'm trying to.
You're holding.
I'm not being the politician.
That's good, that's good.
I don't care, man. I'm not gonna put that much effort into it.
I don't remember the part.
You're so Jimmy Carter.
Do you bring me a beer? I asked him if I want one.
Yeah, but I thought he was
the last one. Oh.
That's alright.
We taking a break?
Oh yeah, I knew this.
So, Jerry, how do you think it's going so far? Or thus far?
Some of it's not bad. Some of it is.
My head hurts. Of course it is. I don't know, I still fool around with the guitar. I write on it, and I still fool around with the keyboard and the bass a little bit, but, you know, having all the ligaments reattached in my left hand, I don't have the strength in my wrist anymore or the flexibility to do what I used to be able to do.
Is that frustrating now that you're trying to get back and play some of the songs you used to play? Is it, do you find it's hindering you, or do you find it... can get by with that?
Well, some of it, like some of the songs that I've written for this, or I had written for the Squirts, I can still play. And some of the ones Andrew's written, I can still play. But some of the ways they want me to, or, you know, if I was to do it the way I did then, some of the leads, I just can't play them as fast as I could then. And some of them, I just can't reach the way I did. And some of the songs that we're doing on this reunion, I don't even think are that necessary. I mean, there's only like four or five songs that people really cared about.
I can't do the lead part.
Let's get your friend to play lead.
That's what I suggested from the start. Get one of the guys from our regular band to do the lead stuff. Either one of them, Matt or Rahul, they're both good lead players.
Why don't we?
Because Paul said he didn't want to have anybody that wasn't in the band.
I mean, it kind of defeats the point if we add another person to it, but... whatever.
I think we should add a person and find a TP head made and make them wear it.
I don't think they'd do that.
Why?
Because it wouldn't be any fun for them.
Chad would do it. I think Chad would enjoy it.
I'm not going to play with Chad or Danny. Those guys are irresponsible.
Chad is irresponsible? What the hell are you talking about?
Neither one of them ever shows up for anything they're supposed to do.
I guess that's how Chad's business is doing so well.
Fine, it's business. I don't give a fuck about it. I'm not going to play with either one of these guys. Bottom line. I'm the guitarist. If we get
the
guitarist,
into
it's going to be somebody I want to play with.
But if you're not putting any effort into it, what's the matter?
Then get somebody else to play. I don't care. I won't do it then.
Well, Matt and Raul don't sound like they have much of a sense of humor, so I don't think they would.
Yeah, they wouldn't. Well. They're more serious. And they'll play the notes like I played them. But they're not gonna wear a toilet paper head or anything. Another thing, I'm not doing a rap. I'm just not gonna fucking do it.
Why?
And that was funny back then. It's not funny now. Not to me. I don't care about it. It was a throwaway song. I mean, I'd like to play some of the songs that we played, learn some new covers, maybe write a few new songs. But drink some beer. But I'm not doing the rap.
I just didn't know you woke up one day and started taking yourself so fucking serious.
That's what I've been doing the past several years. It's been 4.5, 5 years since we played together. I've been doing other stuff. I broke my wrist. I almost died.
That's one of the things you
did. I almost died, so... you know, there's certain things I do now and certain things that I don't want to do.
Well, if you don't want to do it,
we're not going to pull you out, dragging, screaming, and kicking.
You might not be able to play it like you did before, and it might sound like total shit. I don't think it really fucking matters. The whole point is we're up there to have fun. Just come up with something that you can play that's close enough. We're going to sound like shit? Heaven for fucking good.
I'd rather not play a song than try to play something that...
Well, you're making requests, so we're making requests too.
I think what Paul's trying to say is have a little bit of give and take with us. I mean, mm-hmm. we're taking all of your...
Well, the rap is not really give
okay,
and take.
Okay, okay. You don't have to sing the rap.
You're making all the
demands and expecting us to make all the concessions.
There's no concession on that point. I mean, what does it matter? Really, what does it matter to you?
We're not talking about the rap anymore.
Then what other demands have I made?
You don't want to play Big Star. You
I
don't
can't
want to play this.
You don't want to. Yeah, you're not going to take the time to learn your parts, your own parts to the song.
I told you. I was just listening to Skeleton Gang. I played the same thing he did. You were the one saying I played something different.
I did not. The whole point was you said, well, I don't know. What did I play? Well, I don't fucking know what you played. I didn't play your part. You learned it.
I said, I think I was playing the same thing you were. No, you weren't.
I said, I didn't think you were. I don't fucking care either way.
Some of the things that we're doing that we used to do weren't that good of a song to begin with, and I don't know why we're even, I guess, because they're just living in the past. I think that's the problem they all have. I mean, they haven't progressed beyond what the Squirts was. They're still stuck in the past, and they remember it like it was a fun, good old party time, and sometimes it was, but a lot of the times we were at each other's throats. But, you know, those who don't remember the past are condemned to repeat it, and these guys are pretty much condemned.
Now you know why this is a reunion and why we're not still together.
We never watched Sesame Street as a kid. Never learned about cooperation. I mean, just his whole thing with, like, I'm not gonna play no Keith Zarczynski fucking lick. You know, I'm like, dude, I wrote that. That's, you know, that's not Keith. That's my fucking song, and I would appreciate it if you'd at least play my song the way
I
fucking wrote it.
At the same time, everybody's gotta play their shit the best they can and the way they want to.
Dude, all it is three notes.
The same thing Keith left the fucking band over.
All it is three notes.
You're doing the same thing Keith got pissed off
no.
and left the band over, though.
No, Keith got pissed off because Jerry was playing something different every time.
I was.
No, Jerry was like, that's what I play every time, blah, blah, blah. He's like, no, it's not.
Why did he leave the band?
A song which hopefully none of you will ever hear called Miss Contrary. Sappy song that Andrew wrote about his ex-girlfriend Mary, you know, because Mary and Contrary, they rhyme. When I joined the band, it was a song that they already had. And we'd been together for a year or so. And then at practice one time, I was bored. The song is, you know, starts off pretty boring. Keith starts it. Keith wrote the music to it, I think. And so I was playing around on my bass, and I kind of ad-libbed some stuff just to make it more entertaining for me to play. And he seemed to not take too well to the structure of his song being changed, and he got the lock to the storage place we played in out of his pocket, set it down my amp, said, there's the lock, and walked out. And it was the last time he played with us. And then we stopped playing that song live, and it really didn't matter at all.
That's beside the point. I wrote this song, and I wrote that part. Keith didn't come up with that. That's not somebody that's something that somebody improvised.
All right, well, shall we attempt the songs that we didn't finish and
certainly
get through some of them again?
We didn't try to Beer Save My Life.
We'll do that at the end. We don't really need much rehearsal on that. That's the one that I think everybody fucking
I think we need to try beer, too.
And drink worse beer.
Best beer.
One of these won a blue ribbon. The other one just calls themselves the King of Beer, which is a title they stole from Taft, who was the original King of Beer.
Hey, there's three kings in this world. Elvis Presley, Richard Petty, Budweiser.
Taft was the King of Beer long before Budweiser.
Well, nobody drinks that shit. That's considered a swill.
I don't think most people in American society are worth a shit anyway, so that just proves my point.
We're not talking about America. We're talking about the world, babe.
Nobody in the world drinks Budweiser.
It's the biggest selling commodity in the free world. Anheuser-Busch is the biggest selling commodity in the free world.
But is that because people like it or because they're a big marketing machine?
I got fat girl,
this is facts.
Better than you. How about you? You're balding, fat.
Yeah, I'm fat, Jerry. I weigh 145 pounds. I'm so
fucking
huge.
And I weigh 130 pounds.
It's because you're fucking anorexic. All you do is eat fucking grass all day,
yeah.
You cow.
Okay.
I'll never play harmonica again if you never play guitar again.
Okay, then the reunion's canceled. Probably the way he compares his non-ability to the fact that I've actually made money from it.
A big joke that, and he, when we wrote that song Leaving Texas, I remember him rehearsing or trying to rehearse a harmonica part, and it's pretty funny, I guess, because that is not harmonica playing. I really don't know what it is. I mean, you might as well have had a kazoo.
Playing guitar for 17 years and haven't learned a damn thing since day one.
Why don't you get the fuck out of my house? That's the next song. Why don't you get the fuck out of my house? In fact, I think that would be the new Squirt song I write. Why don't you get the fuck out of my house? Yeah, when I look at the three of you guys and I think about my life sucks. And when I look at the three of you guys, I'm like, damn, and I'm pretty close to Nirvana. So it's pretty amusing. Yeah, very much.
Glad you're laughing.
I never did. No, very much.
I'm really glad you're laughing.
I never knew Nirvana was that so close to sea level, for Christ's sake.
Oh, shut up. You're going to be living with your parents, Sam. What are you talking about?
Not really.
Yeah. Moving out of Athens to move back to Clemson to work at some shithole restaurant.
That's all he likes.
Living with my parents.
He likes his parents.
Yeah.
My parents were nice to me.
My parents are nice to me too. They just let me pay for what I was doing instead of
paying
for it
for
me.
Okay, Jerry, I pay for everything now.
Oh, yeah, that was a nice new car. Yeah, you were able to afford that?
Yes, actually, I was. I paid $222 a month for it. It's used, thank you. It's $19.99.
Oh, in $19.99? I got an 87.
Good for you.
But yeah, I did definitely pay for
maybe
it.
Maybe if I didn't have $80,000 worth of hospital bills because I jumped out a window, you know, I wouldn't have to worry about my dog.
My girlfriend threw me out of the window.
I'm sure she did.
Oh, yeah, you're bragging about that?
I'm bragging.
Your girlfriend threw you out of the window.
She did.
Good for her.
Bad bitch.
Let's just say the girl I was living with had some pretty severe problems and I drank excessively, just not facing up to the problems that she had, or trying to deny them, I guess. And one night, I'm really not sure of the exact circumstances, but somehow I fell out of a three-story building and broke the left side of my body.
I don't know if I'm gonna do this thing.
I'm borrowing, so
that's be as kind as I can.
What's wrong?
I don't know if I'm gonna do this, man. Two practices, I'm sick of that fucker. Talentless mother piece of shit.
I hate to tell you guys this, but this is a definite demand of what, since we're practicing here. And since I did not drink, I had 18 beers, and now I've got 8 left. I didn't drink 10 beers. You guys can rehearse. You guys are buying me beers and fucking.
Dude, I didn't drink one of your beers, man.
They disappear.
Well,
I
don't feel happy about this.
I drank the one beer I asked you for, man. I had a fucking six pack, dude. What need do I have of your
beer?
No,
I didn't fucking drink them.
Nobody here
drinking
beers, man.
I did not drink any beers. I'm very upset about that.
You didn't drink how many beers?
10. I had 18 when you guys came over.
I don't know. You sound
I have
like
8.
10.
Nevertheless.
Exactly. Next
time, when you guys come, you're practicing in my house.
Nobody drank your damn beer, Jerry. Nobody.
I don't care. You guys come to my house, you're practicing in my house, buy me fucking beer.
What?
A six pack. There's going to be no fucking beer in the refrigerator next time you guys show up. You want a drink?
Okay.
That's fine. I brought my beer this time.
Well, that pisses me off.
Dude, I'm not doing this.
Nah, hold on.
You can finish up your movie now. No,
hold
I'm
on.
Not doing it, dude.
Mm-mm.
I'm not dealing with his.
This is on camera now, too.
Good.
No.
He's
on camera. He does not win.
He's a piece of shit.
You're right. He does not win.
He's a fucking
piece of shit. He does not win.
Piece of shit, dude.
He does not win. This is on camera. He does not win.
Before you lock us out, I'm going to go get my beer out of the fridge.
Good. Take the rest of it.
My beer, not your beer.
No, I didn't drink that fucking.
How many cans did you see me with tonight? I had bottles.
Don't fucking know. Don't fucking care.
Huh?
Don't fucking know. Don't fucking care.
What the hell's up with this? I broke your refrigerator with my beer, and now I go in and I got one left. I know I didn't drink 11 beers.
I don't drink that.
Yeah, I know you were drinking my fucking beer.
You're just making random accusations.
Find another place to practice. I give a fuck. I'm really concerned. I can tell you, you're not drinking fucking beers. So I'm saving us half of those for tomorrow night. At least you could take the fucking empty beers out of my fucking house.
Well, that was calculated.
Oh no, it's green. I'm the one that has to live here. Would you kick that door closed, please?
There's a screen up.
Yeah. For the record, I hate these fucking guys. They fucking suck. I think about you and Nathan and most of the people I know and how your lives probably are fucking abysmal.
And how we're all probably
just slit your
and
wrist.
And how we're all probably a lot happier than you.
Why don't you just slit your wrist? No,
so,
no.
Yeah, well, we're happy.
Actually, I'm thinking about why don't you just slit that fucking wrist?
Because I'm happy.
What do you got to live for?
Nothing. I don't need anything to live for. I like being alive.
Then why don't you fucking die? Why don't you just kill yourself?
What did I just say? Are you paying attention to the conversation?
Yeah, yeah,
or
but you're not giving me a reason that
I don't need a reason. I like being me. That's good enough reason to be alive.
Being you.
Yeah.
I can jerk off to internet porn at 3 o'clock in the morning. That's a good reason to be alive.
No, it's usually
no,
5
I think
o'clock
it's a good reason
morning.
To kill yourself.
And sometimes it's videotapes, too.
That's a good reason to kill yourself.
I started this fucking band. The only reason he was ever in it was because I couldn't fucking find anybody else. You know what I'm saying?
At least before he was into it. I mean,
yeah.
He was into
now
it
he's got this whole self-conscious
yeah,
thing about his new band.
His directions in life have changed.
He still looks the same as it did 4 years ago.
Yeah, you're still.
It looks worse.
You're still fucking raging.
Because now he got thrown. Because now he got thrown by his girlfriend out a window.
Yeah, bullshit.
Who cares? That's the worst way you could put it.
That's not what happened.
I know. But would you rather say I accidentally fell, or would you rather say my girlfriend picked me up and threw me through a window? I mean, I would rather be accidentally fall than have my girlfriend throw me.
What actually happened?
The way I hear it is
I don't
he
know.
Didn't accidentally fall.
There was no accident.
He was climbing out the window
yeah, to get her
to
in the bathroom
from the police.
Oh.
Because she called the police.
I heard she had locked herself in the bathroom and he was trying to get her to beat her.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he,
she locked herself in the bathroom because
he
was beating her.
He had been beating her. And she locked herself in the bathroom and called the police. And when the police started banging
there were other times when people had to like interfere and keep him from beating her. So
when the police started banging on the door, he climbed out the window to hide from them and fell.
Well, if someone's resorting that fucking story, you know what really happened? That's pretty bad. So I got no use for
him. Dude, I say if we can get Chad, man, let's boot him. I don't want to play with him. I really don't.
No, it's taking on the final.
It just, it's just a waste of my fucking time, dude. Because I don't look forward to coming over here. I really don't. I mean, that's just my bottom line. And if we don't
get Chad or somebody else to replace him, but I don't want to do it.
What about Keith? And it'll be hard working out practicing.
And Keith would be better. If he could fucking come down here, I'd better have Keith.
I would too.
He would come down here for just...
Like I said, at least Keith has rhythm. Keith dingling, Keith tingling, can't get nobody to play with Keith dingling.
Except for me. You met any hot chicks up there in Pulaski lately?
At the steakhouse?
I just recently went out with a chick who has two kids.
You meet her at the turkey shoot?
Yeah. But that was kind of an interesting relationship.
I'm sure it was.
She had a 3-year-old and a 1.5-year-old.
Fortunately, Keith's a pedophile.
He's from around here. I don't know if he's from Greenville or Clemson. I think he went, maybe lived in both. I don't know. I met him when he was going to school at Clemson. Alcoholic. Sold most of his possessions to buy alcohol. You know, sold off all his CDs, everything he owned to keep drinking. Finally kind of got his act together. I don't know if he ever finally graduated from college or not. Nice guy. Like I said, he's really subdued. He's not an in-your-face type of person.
Okay, wait. Whose glasses were that?
Those are Michael's glasses right there.
So you're already broken.
Who the hell are you? I'm going to be the dude that's going to put those fucking wheels in the goddamn gutter.
Against the wall, I know you wanna watch me crawl, but I'll never get down on my knees for you.
You're in the movie.
Hey, Andrew, wait.
What? Go ahead, Mr. Springer.
I want to know your opinion of the Squirts. As musician.
Are they still a band? For real? Are they like getting back together? Like the VH1 thing where they get back together, like when the Behind the Music happens? Is that what the Squirts are doing?
They're doing a reunion tour.
They are.
What did you think about their music?
Do I have to answer with Mr. Wood and his color tattoos?
Could you put a little pink in my tattoo, please? I like a little orange and a little pink.
Right here.
Tell me the facts.
We're doing a reunion tour. We just kicked
Jerry out of the band. Me, Paul, Peter, and Chad Thompson. That's the fucking
band. Who the fuck
band.
Is Peter?
John Truesdale, Moose Boy, fucking
okay.
The drummer for
the guy I never knew.
Pretty good drummer.
Good. All right, drummer. Say it again. You,
me, Peter, Chad, and Paul. Paul Shivery.
Paul Shivery is still alive.
Yeah. Yes, he is.
You're sure?
Yes, he is. I'm pretty sure. Right. I saw him the other night.
So tell me about this tour. See, before I can answer these questions, I need to know.
Because we're going to try and set up a show here, Clemson, Roanoke, and Charleston. Do like a 4-city tour. And just like travel around and
kill
each other.
Who's gonna book the show?
I don't know.
I'm not booking shows for you.
Well, I didn't ask you to.
I just knew that's where that was going.
Nah.
So who's booking the shows? Who's your agent?
I'll book a show in Charleston and Roanoke, and we're gonna try and do like a party in Clemson, and then here. I mean, you know, I just talk to whoever the fuck I know and that has a band and see if we can fucking set up a show somewhere. Man. I mean, fuck right. You, dude. I don't need you to set up a show for me.
I don't want to set up
okay,
a show for you.
Okay, you fucking old bastard.
All right, come on, I'm about to fall asleep. Give me this. I'll ask them to myself. What do you think of the Squirts? I don't think you're going to be able to book the shows for this reunion tour because no one's going to book them. Tell me about...
Well, Tim, wait. First, tell me about what do you think of them as people?
As
or
people?
At least, you probably only know one or two of them.
I know Andrew is a very good person. See, look, you got to hand him.
and who else is in the band?
Paul.
Chad is Daniel's brother. Something wrong there. And Paul, I didn't know you were still alive. So, does that answer that? I don't know the Beaver guy. What's his name?
Beaver.
Beaver. And so I don't know about him. Tell me about including the squirts on a Ghost Meat comp. I didn't know that I had, but I guess I did. So, good for them.
Actually, not too long after I joined the band, the song Leaving Texas was put on a compilation, Ghost Meat Records compilation, all about numbers. We don't really fit in with, but that song kind of fits in with some of the other bands on the CD. I don't think in general that we fit in with those bands, but we're friends with the guy who owns Ghost Meat, so I think it was kind of he had room for another track. I'll put these guys on there too.
Will the Squirts be able to book a show in Athens? I already answered that. No. Not without my help. Is that enough?
That'll be fine.
And,
Well, just first, the Squirts music. What do you think of the music? Have you heard them play?
I don't remember at the Rumor show. And, I have to go back and listen to the song that I apparently put on the comp, because I don't remember it.
This is just a lark. It's just a one-time thing for me. Like I said, for our fans in Roanoke and around here in Clemson and friends in Athens and whoever may be in Charleston, I don't know. Maybe some of our friends are there, maybe not. That would just be, another place to play. But it's mostly just to give, some of our friends who used to come see us, who are now married and have kids and don't get out a whole lot, or just, for them to reminisce in the past and for us to reminisce in the past with them. But that's the important thing. The Squirts is the past. It's a reunion, not a reformation. I have no intention of doing anything beyond these reunion shows.
Let's get back. We have this guy in the background of the shot.
Who?
There's this guy in the background of the shot smoking unfiltered camels. Now, tell me, what's going on?
Our guitarist is no longer with the band, for one reason or another.
Look, my lighter, I was reaching for it, and I'm like, where the fuck is it? It's in the secret pocket.
It's in the lighter pocket.
How did that happen?
In the lighter pocket, change pocket.
The hell?
So, we need to get a new guitarist. The very first person we thought of was you.
Why, thank you.
Because we like you and we wanted to play with you and you're a good guitarist. Of course, obviously you agreed to it, so you're here with us. It's been 2 days since the last time you saw. The day after Jerry was an asshole, we made contact, and you see, we move fast. We're motivated. We're organized. You've seen that before, though.
For one thing, we're practicing here at my house, and that's kind of. It's not that big of a deal, but I don't want, when I say 7 o'clock or whatever time we're supposed to practice, I want to show up, practice, get the hell out. I don't want to really have to deal with them beyond the fact that we're doing this reunion. When it's not like I hang out with these guys or call them up or anything.
I just talked to Jerry tonight.
Right.
He's expecting to practice Sunday afternoon. Does he know that he's out of the band?
Because of some technical aspects, the fact that you still needed to interview. And the fact that he's got some goods that we need to get copies of before.
Some goods.
He's got a couple videotapes, live performances, some audio. And because you've seen his attitude sometimes when things don't go his way, we're afraid that he'll either destroy them or at least not let us have access to them after he finds us out. So we're going to try and make duplicates of everything we need before he is told.
Yeah.
Any words for Jerry J? Yeah, I don't want to practice at your place anymore. It's your house. I'll get out.
You used to be cool.
Y'all ever heard of the Squirts?
Yes, we have.
Squirts fucking rule! Woo!
Thanks, Tim.
Yeah!
Don't look at me because I'm getting myself in the glasses.
All right, well, you got to ask me thought-provoking questions. We're out here on the bench.
Why would you join the Squirts?
Well, I've known them for a while. And I haven't played guitar in about 9 years, so I should fit right in.
Have you seen them play before?
Yeah, I don't remember, but yeah, I've seen them play.
So in your mind, that may be good.
I doubt that. I doubt that. Seriously. So, like I said, I should fit right in, you know?
And I'm gonna wrap this up in a nutshell. This is what we're doing here. JJ Squirts, right? Point A. What we're gonna do is we're gonna carry it over to point B. Okay? With me. All right? With me. See what I'm saying?
He was a total fucking asshole. I wanted to take Jerry back, cut him some slack, and give him a second chance. No, fuck no. He's a dick. There wasn't even a camera there. He was just a drunken asshole.
What'd he do?
Talking shit about us. He's created his own version of the end of the band and how we were all wrong and he was right.
Revisionist history, I think.
Yeah, he's the winner rewrites the history. He's the winner.
Are you close? Yeah. All right, you little fucker.
So insignificant, but...
Hey, did you like Star Wars last night? You didn't.
Yeah, I'll get that on film.
You thought it sucked?
Don't bother coming over.
Are you serious? We're gonna whoop your ass when you get here. We loved it. Get here. Bye. Bye. Dude, we're whooping some ass. I'm right here, yeah. Slightly before 10 o'clock. What time is it?
9:30.
Just stop right there.
Sorry that I was late. I didn't get off work until 8 o'clock tonight.
Sorry.
I was working on vinyl in the house.
But are you serious about not liking the movie last night?
Yeah, it was pretty good, man.
We just loved it, man.
When you're sleep deprived, it had some slow enough points in it, though, that really...
Yeah, it did, and I was really tired. Did you?
Not, I mean, just for a split second.
I couldn't fall asleep, but because of the damn fucking volume of it.
When they're like, oh, I love you, and I was like...
Hey, we're going down here, Chad.
Okay.
Oh, love me, baby.
Oh, cool, there's plenty of room down here, man. Hey, Paul.
I see a ship in the heart.
Sorry for my belatedness.
Whatever, bitch. You got the white hat? I got the black hat. We can see what's going on already.
You're Bart and Fart.
Damn. Hell, and he carries his own shit, too.
I hear that train coming.
It's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen sunshine. I don't know when I'm fucking moving through.
What do you think of the new incarnation of the Squirts?
Well, I think they've improved drastically. I mean, Chad's such a good guitarist. He's just falling right in with it. They smell better, also. I like his little funky hat he's wearing. And there's no velvet. I really like that.
Well. Do you have any bad feelings that Jerry is
no longer with the band?
I don't know, you know. I like Jerry and everything, but he can be such a pompous ass sometimes, and it seems to bring everybody down, you know. So I kind of like this better, personally, you know.
What we want you to get out of playing with us is the feel of the song.
Right.
The attitude of the song. That's all that fucking matters.
That and as much drinking as possible.
The musical crap is second to knowing what the song is about and being able to feel it. Like all music.
Uh-oh.
Oh, the cameraman fucked shit up, man.
We're talking about how wonderful Chad is.
Yeah.
He can actually play the guitar.
I haven't heard distortion in I don't know how many years. My ears are ringing like they haven't rung in a long time.
Well, dude, we don't have to stop him with his song so he can figure out where we are. I mean, if he lags behind, he like figures out.
He'll cover it up
in just a second. You know, okay. He'll fucking cover it up, and he'll be like right there. I mean, it's not like wait. What are you guys playing? Where am I? Who am I? And it is like it's sweet. Once he takes that fucking CD home, learns those songs. We're fucking money.
We were talking about if Jerry died, we could play at his funeral.
That'd be cool.
And we'd sound good since he was dead.
This is the way Jerry should have sounded when he was alive, but he didn't because he sucked.
No, we'll say, hey, Jerry, no offense, but glad you're dead, Bennett.
No offense.
Jerry used to play with us, but now he's dead.
I thought the shit I said earlier was bad, but he's totally taking the cake right now.
Jerry, man, you were fucking cool as shit, but you were such a dick the past couple weeks. You fucking, if you get a problem with it, bring your bony ass.
You're a dick.
On up in here.
A lot of the times, the people I play with, you know, are afraid to say something because they're like, oh, he's a singer, you know, he's the guitar player and he writes pretty much everything, but that's never been true. I've always encouraged everybody to add what they thought was a good idea, and then if it just didn't work, like we'd try it my way and their way, and if my way was better, that was fine, but if their way was better, that was fine as well. But the Squirts just wanted to stick with this basic, you know, real elementary punk rock. And I think a lot of it was just attitude on their part, you know. They can sneer at everybody and act all, fuck the world, and, but, you know, it was, you know, after a while, after 2 years of doing the same old thing, it's just too bloody long, you know. There's other things to do. I don't want to do that forever, though. I guess these guys wouldn't mind, like, retreading the same crap over and over again. Like, what else do they do? They don't do anything else.
Hello? Hey. Not too much. We are going to have drums. We're just going to be starting later than we thought we were going to. Yeah, because Chris's drums were over at Spore's house, so Peter's going over to Spore's house now to go pick him up. Okay. All right, Chad. Bye.
Where is he?
He's at home. He called earlier. He got off of work late. He always says he always will. So when you're your own boss,
you want to get him right now.
Who's he? Who's
he didn't he? Buy him. He's going to get Chris's from Spore's house. Yeah, he's only got, you know, like $24,000 saved up. How's he supposed to afford, you know, an $800 drum set?
Peter, get some drums.
What you drinking?
Pabst. You've never seen Pabst in the clear bottle? Hey, this was something left over.
This was free. Hey, we made a rule when we first moved in here. Anybody who left any beer here, it's fair game when you leave.
Hey, cool, only an hour and a half late.
I'm sorry, dude.
Everybody else left.
Everybody else left?
Nobody else fucking wanted to wait.
For what?
You.
You couldn't go downstairs and teach him songs without me singing?
I'm fucking kidding.
Nobody else has
Chad
been.
Chad hadn't even got here yet. My God. Peter went to go get drums.
Peter went to go get drums?
He had to go to Spore's house to go pick up Chris's drums.
Oh, Chris said it was cool?
Yeah.
Cool.
That's your song.
What the hell's it doing there?
All my songs I pitched over to the hallway.
I got all your porn in the car, man. Don't let me forget to give it back to you.
Yeah, exactly. I couldn't go on with my life without those tapes.
You want some porn?
Yeah, just pass it over to
Beater. You live with your parents. You need to jack your dick, I'm sure.
Just pass it on to Beater.
Okay. There's a couple little highlights in there. It takes 5 or 6 hours to get
hand me down porn.
I got some maggots.
It's all sticky.
Easy to transport. No need a VCR. You can just jack your dick wherever you are, man.
Get some what?
It's a song.
No need for a VCR. You can jack your dick wherever you are.
Great.
Of course, I know you to do that all.
So back to my question about where's Chad. Are we going?
He's on his way.
What the fuck are you doing?
Astro scientist.
God damn it. Yes,
John Carradine. He's my favorite actor.
Holy shit.
Jerry Bryant.
Oh my
you
God.
Can't. Oh shit.
Talk to him. Talk
no,
to him.
No, we can't. There's
talk
no way everybody will be quiet during that conversation.
There's no way in hell anybody will be quiet during that fucking conversation.
Two Kings. No, Mark. Hey, Jerry, we're shaking, man. I don't know. Hold on. Let me go see. He might be in the bathroom.
Hey, Jerry.
What's up?
About 12 beers away from being drunk. Hell, I don't know. Maybe the whole thing's just gonna end up getting, like, put on hold. No, I talked to him. I don't know what day it was. Was it today, Thursday?
Yesterday or
Tuesday, and he said I know he's going to the beach next week, and he was, like, trying to work some extra hours this week before he went. So he wasn't going to be able to film any. And he might have talked to Andrew and just told him since he wanted to get all the films on practice, or practice on film, that he didn't want to, you know, want us to wait or something. I don't know. Hell if I know. Yeah, well, maybe we can see about just getting together and playing, even while Michael's gone, just to get together and play. Well, I don't know. With Michael in front of us with a camera, I don't think that's going to dwindle away. I don't know. I think that'll change it some. Yeah. Yep, let me run. I got pissed really fucking bad. Okie dokie. All right, Jerry. Bye.
What the hell? That's so fucking terrible.
Michael's right in front of me with a camera.
That's all I said.
No, I mean, that's what, like, you know, I interpreted because I've had two beers.
Okay, what'd he say? Let's.
Nothing. He asked if I knew what was going on. And
same conversation we had.
Yeah, same conversation I've had with him like 3 times over the past 2 weeks.
Well, tell me, what is your decision about.
Well, he's out of the bag.
I know. I mean, what is your decision about telling him? What have you decided?
We are going to have to do.
I say we get like a Sky Rider. Jared, you're out of the Squirts.
You paying for it?
Like, no.
Right, okay. There's the Sky Rider right there.
You can come in, Chad.
Thank you.
Hey, man.
Are we actually going to play?
He does kind of look like Johnny, doesn't he?
Peter, are the drums in the basement?
No.
Then what are you doing up here?
Yeah. What are you doing up here?
You are the one who is the ball that
my microphone is set up.
I'm right.
Oh, did you bring me an amp thing there?
No. So your microphone's not set up, is it?
Did you need a fucking amp, dude?
He didn't bring an amp.
I didn't even fucking think about an amp.
Well, he's plugging. Did you bring your stack?
No, I just brought my little amp, man.
playing. Well, I got a little practice, Andy. You can try. It sucks, but
I'm sorry, Andrew. You want me to bring it next week, man?
Yeah, every week until I get an amp.
Name is Spider-Man.
You?
Those things fucking rock, man.
I'll just fucking hang it from the ceiling, man. We'll probably project that shit on.
You
all
might pull the whole house down, too. So don't.
The Squire 15 was wild, man.
Okay, Jerry Curl, what's going on tonight?
I'm drinking beer. I've been asleep for most of the day. I drank earlier today and remained unconscious for the latter part of the afternoon and woke up and ate, and here I am drinking again.
So you say this week you heard that the Squirts continued without you. What's your thoughts, man?
Well, I really, you know, I'm not paid to think, obviously. But I don't know. It's fairly amusing to me, since they are talentless. But you know, I guess you know, that particular genre of music doesn't necessarily facilitate any ability to do much of anything except swear at your audience and drink massive quantities of booze. Though I could still put them all under the table with my own drinking ability.
Are you going to say anything to him tonight?
No. Why should I?
You don't let them speak for themselves.
I suppose. I'll let them make asses of themselves.
Hi. Squirts rule.
Squirts do rule. You know that already, though.
Fucking life away for this shit.
You guys gonna kiss?
Sure.
You get that? You fucking better have.
But
you better have. Got that.
Oh my god.
Shave, man. Shave.
You're tickling my fucking chin, man.
I'll shake your hand.
No, kiss him.
Kiss him. Kiss him. Kiss him, Peter.
Tell her his dad told me you were pissed off, and I was like,
I thought you were talking shit, but I guess you're
no, I was just spinning around, I didn't know anything was going on.
Okay.
Because I was just fucking with you, just like normal fucking.
I got pissed, I thought you were. I thought
that's what Nate told me, I was like, why is he pissed off? And then I found out the Squirts team. Actually, I should be pissed off because nobody told me.
I also thought you were known because.
Nobody told me. I found out 4 days ago.
Shut and do this.
could do tonight. Jerry Bryan, the whitest boy in the whole fucking world, is gonna do a rap for you.
I never tried to walk a straight line. I'm the biggest loser of all time.
Here we go.
Jerry, you're a fan.
Thank you.
Oh, you want to hear some Tom Fogerty?
Ladies and gentlemen!